Charles celebrates 50 years in music with Michael Bolton, the Brand New Heavies, Tevin Campbell, Bill Cosby, Gloria Estefan, Hammer, James Ingram, Quincy Jones, Gladys Knight, Paul McCartney, Michael McDonald, Garrett Morris, Willie Nelson, Emma Sands, James Stevens III, Robert Townsend, Randy Travis, and Stevie Wonder.
You got the right one, baby. All right, we'll get to that. I'll teach you guys how to do that. I'll teach you how to do it bilingually, actually. Okay? Oh, I feel good. Anytime you can see a Latino in a tuxedo, and I'm not serving more butter. Okay. Thank you very much. Latinos in tuxes on the next Geraldo. I'd like to now tell you about the women that I've slept with. Yeah, a kiss and tell, Geraldo. Yeah, very nice. He slept with 8 women. I think if I slept with 8 women, I wouldn't tell nobody shit. Oh, yeah, the list is too extensive to go into now. Oh, what a day. What is it? September the 19th, the first day of summer. 100 degrees, September the 19th. July, 40. I almost lost my tan. But I don't like to lay out and get too dark. You can't get too dark. You don't want to get too dark, like, you know, when you go to a jewelry store, they follow you around. You don't want to get that dark. That happens to me a lot. I go to Rodeo Drive. What did they stop me for last time? Attempted window shopping. I think that's what I'm doing. But it's also another very special occasion, 50 years of making music for Ray Charles. 50 years. 50 years. And also, a double pleasure, it's his 61st birthday this weekend. Yes. One thing before I leave, Ray Charles as the show is closing, will say, that's the first 50 years of music. Do you want another 50? And I want all of you people to say, aha! Can you do that?
Aha!
Don't forget. Enjoy the show. My name is George Lopez. Thank you very much for coming. Peace.
Ladies and gentlemen, Hammer.
Good evening. We're here tonight to celebrate the career of a man who has been making music longer than a lot of his biggest fans have been alive. I'm just one example. To kick off our celebration tonight, Academy Award winner Stevie Wonder. Back when Stevie Wonder was little Stevie Wonder, He even titled one of his early albums For Uncle Ray. Tonight, he has used his influence to get Ray to perform a duet with him for the first time ever on stage. Just the two of them. It gives me a great deal of pleasure to present to you your designated drivers, Little Stevie Wonder and Uncle Ray Charles.
And the mud in the streets and all the drugs and the rape are going around. I have my electricity cut off. My gas don't burn no more. And even the water has stopped flowing. And my poor family is cold and hungry. Oh, Lord, why has God forsaken me? His hair long, his feet are hard and bitter.
Right.
He spent his life walking the streets of New York City. He's almost dead. Air pollution. He tried to vote, but to him there's no solution. Maybe just enough. Lord, just enough for Cindy.
I hope you hear inside my voice of sorrow, and that I'm only meant to make a better tomorrow. This place is cruel. No, what?
Hi there, Paul McCartney speaking. Hi, Ray. Listen, when I was a kid, when I was a teenager in Liverpool, a radio was playing a certain song one day. This song was called What Did I Say? It was probably one of the greatest musical thrills of my life when I first heard that song. It combined jazz and soul and rock and roll, and it knocked me for six. That meant I was from then on a very big fan of the great Ray Charles. I want to thank you, Ray. I want to add my little bit to this tribute. I love you, baby. Rock on forever.
One, two,
As a singer, I admire him for the control, range, the believability in his voice.
I'm a stranger of strange in my hometown.
You know, how does a person sing that true all the time?
Some folks I've known since my childhood just don't seem to want me around.
He just has that that voice. It's a voice of longing, of hoping. It sounds as if it's filled with all of the joy of an experience.
Ray has a certain kind of cry in his voice, some kind of thing, I don't know what it is, and his ability to go up there in that falsetto and do things. He's just a master at what he does.
Love, just enough for the city I'm living, just enough.
He's so unique in his delivery and his commitment to every word, to every phrase when he sings, that people just respond to it. It's not like some average person or even just a great singer singing. There's something extra. There's something very special.
Y'all listen to me. I came home with good intentions. Oh, help me. About 5 or 6 years ago, Jesus helped me. I came home with good intentions. Lord, it was just about 5 or 6 years ago. But my hometown won't accept me, and I just don't feel welcome here no more. I don't. Pick it for me, son.
The real big difference is the ability to pay attention to details. Everybody I've known is great. That's the one singular thing that they have, is a moment where everybody else would say, that's good enough. They'd say, it's not good enough, you know, and there's that little detail that they want to fix and make better.
I realize there's some here that like me, but there's so very, very few, though. I'm not stranger, no. Stranger in my own hometown. My so-called friends stop being friendly, but they can't keep a good man down. I'm like a stranger, stranger in my own hometown. I'm a stranger, no. Stranger. No. My so-called friends, I've been friendly, but they can't keep a good man down. They can't keep me down.
I think that's true. I think he does have music in his blood. I think that's why he's so great at what he does.
Ladies and gentlemen, Robert Townsend.
Thank you, thank you. Ray has never been one to deny his problems. In fact, he's taken most of them and put them in songs and made most of us aware of his problems. When Ray got busted, the whole world finds out about it in one way or another. Listen to him tell it his way with a little help from a good friend from Texas who knows what he's singing about, Mr. Willie Nelson.
Well, cutting it down. Quiet on pound, but I'm busted out. To ask for a loan, cause I was busted.
Tell me about it.
Lord, I hate to beg like a dog for a bone, but I was busted.
I know what you mean.
But my brother said there ain't nothing that I can do. My wife and my kids are all down with the flu. I was just thinking about calling on you, cause I'm busted.
Now.
Well, the fields are all bare and the cotton won't grow.
All right.
And my family and I had to pack up and go.
Oh, Lord, have mercy.
I'll make a living, Lord, how I don't know, but I'm busted.
I ain't got no money.
I ain't got no money.
I'm talking about empty pockets.
I mean, zero is where we start from now, brother.
Oh, forget it.
Could you let me have $2?
My chest problem. All right.
Ladies and gentlemen, here's a special tribute to Ray Charles from England's The Brand New Heavies.
Never stop.
Ladies and gentlemen, Quincy Jones.
Thank you. Right around the time that Ray Charles was being born in Albany, Georgia, a song was being born in the minds of Hoagy Carmichael and Stuart Gorrell, and it was called Georgia. Since then, Georgia has been on a lot of minds, and the legislature made it the official state song. TV's Designing Women have made it their theme, and now a bright new star has taken it and refashioned it and made it his own hit. Ladies and gentlemen, Georgia on my mind.
You know the little girls. and gentlemen, Mr. Michael Bolton.
I've been very fortunate, sweetheart. I had a lot of wonderful things happen to me, and I think that when I look at my life, I have to say that when you look at the percentage, I probably come out about 70-30 or 75-25 to the good, and I don't think anybody can argue with that. I mean, I don't think anyone should complain with that type of a percentage.
Definitely no one sounds the way that Ray sounds. There have been those that have sounded similar and kind of like him. And I think that too is a very unique thing too, because without question, if you hear someone that's sounding like them, like that someone that's sounding like him, you immediately say, hey, that sounds like Ray Charles.
Yeah, give him that two bars. Y'all like that, man. Yeah, do that. All right. Goddamn. Lord, for how that's mistaken me. I'm sitting around here with all these rats and the roaches and murder in the streets and all the drugs and the thing, and I can't find a job nowhere. I'm looking all around me, and all I can see, my electricity has been turned off. My water don't flow no more, and even my my landlord has put me out in the street. Lord, why hast thou forsaken me? It's had long, but he is so much prettier. He's pretty life. Living in the streets of New York City. He's almost dead from being air pollution. He's turning on. But to me, that's no solution. Living gas in there.
Oh, I would hope that some of Ray Charles would rub off on me. I think any singer or musician in the world would, on the planet, would hope that some of Ray Charles would rub off, because he's the best. Well, he does it with his gut feeling and plus his incredible talent. And you put those two together, and that's Ray Charles.
Well, I went to my brother to ask for a loan, because I was busting. I said, I hate to beg like a dog for a bone, but I was busting.
All right.
Born to do this. It's not hard for him to do this.
Thinking about calling on you on the bus.
All right. That's great. I'm a victim. Oh, that's it. That's it. That worked.
The first time I heard Ray's music, I was eight or nine years old. And the song that I best remember was What I Say. Tell me what I say.
I think I was 8 years old in Akron, Ohio, and it was wintertime, and he came on the radio.
sir.
I can't stop loving you.
So wait a minute.
He's one of those people that's so versatile, he can do it all and sound equally convincing on country, and then pop, then something blues, or whatever he's doing.
He's a genius. Genius. He's a genius in every sense of the word because of his understanding of music. You know what I'm saying? He's one of the few great masters that's left. You know, he's not just a singer. He's a piano player. He's a composer. He understands music. I mean, I've been in a studio with him where he, that cello back there, that B flat that you're playing, it's wrong. I've changed that to, I'm saying, where is he? You know what I'm saying? The man's ears and his whole thing and his expression is the greatest.
You should never forget the simple fact that 50 years in this business, Ray Charles has taken standard tunes that we've all pretty much taken for granted and then put some electricity into them. Something that makes you see the song, not necessarily differently, but see the song as the songwriter would want you to feel it. And we're talking about, oh, what a beautiful morning. It's a beautiful morning. Happy birthday, Ray.
Ladies and gentlemen, the comedy of James Stevens III.
Oh, yeah.
You guys supposed to know your vowels. But it's fun, you know, you're hanging out with these people. It's like me. This is like a show of shows for me. I mean, can't believe all the people on the show. You see all these people on this show, man? They got Michael McDonald. You felt like you were in church, didn't you? Michael McDonald, he's great. Black people love him because he sings real well, but you can't understand anything he says. He did a song with Patti LaBelle. You remember that tune, On My Own, Baffle People All Over the World? Run upon the train, hopping and hopping. Run upon the sailor, Bobby. Run upon the sailor, Bobby. Bobby, for the sailor, Bobby. I can't believe it. I see all my favorite singers. See, all my favorite singers are on here, man. I was thinking, why didn't they have Prince on the show? So I see Prince would probably sing What I Say a different way. See the girl with the red vest on. Oh yeah, tell me what I. See, one thing I hope after this is I hope that Ray doesn't become too big of a legend. You understand? Because you know, you become a big legend, then what happened? You disappear. See what happened to Elvis? No, don't worry about Elvis. I was playing basketball with Elvis all day. Now, Elvis has moved to Compton. Changed his name to Melvis. I'm out on the court, all of a sudden this guy comes out. Oh, how you doing, man? Okay, give me the ball. Oh. And the brothers hate playing with him. Yo, man, I hate playing with the king. You know his way he's moving, his way his legs moving. Doesn't bother Melvis.
Oh, wow, man.
He gets angry, he gets in the middle of the court, starts to whine, starts to sing.
Come on, little brother, won't you pass the ball to the left? Come on, little brother, won't you pass the ball to the right? Cause you won't pass the basketball. Oh, hello, thank you.
Three of Ray's biggest hits were songs about love sung in three different styles, and we've gathered three seriously different singers to show to you, show the songs to you. From the world of pop, the extraordinary Michael McDonald. From the city, the extremely urbane, extremely contemporary Mr. James Ingram. And from the country, please welcome the multiple award-winning Randy Travis. Bring him on!
You're cheating, heart, will make you win. You'll cry. But sleep won't come the whole night through. Your cheating heart will tell on you. When tears come down like falling, you'll toss around and call my name. You'll walk the floor the way I do. You'll cheat. Time is to steal.
all the lonesome times. It's useless to say, so I'll just live my life in dreams of yesterday.
Fusses, always treats me right, and I run in the streets, leaving me alone. She knows a woman's place is around there.
Take a moment to pay tribute to a man who has definitely inspired not only his audiences, but I think every performer that's ever listened to him. It's Ray Charles, and it's his birthday. And we want it from Detroit, everyone in Detroit, to sing him a very happy birthday. Are you ready?
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday.
ladies and gentlemen, Emma Sands.
The first time I heard a Ray Charles record was when I was a child in England. Rhythm and blues had crossed the Atlantic and kids made it their anthem. It's very appropriate that tonight's magnificent show benefits kids. So many of us were influenced by Ray when we were very young. In fact, some of us may have been conceived because I Can't Stop Loving You was on the record player. But I'd rather not think about that. I'm sure you wouldn't either. The proceeds from tonight's performance will go to the Starlight and Starbright Foundations, organizations organizations that every day help make the dreams of seriously ill children come true. So on behalf of all the children who will be helped as a result of this evening, I thank you all very, very much. Our next performer was discovered by Quincy Jones, who featured him on his sensational Back on the Block album. This young man's future is star bright, Mr. Tevin Campbell.
Thank you. It is a trip to be able to share this stage with so many people I've spent my whole life idolizing. I absolutely love Ray Charles, believe me, and I'm absolutely glad and thrilled to bring him back to sing for you. This is one of a small group of songs Ray recorded in 1959 for the first time using strings. I mean, that was a very bold move for an R&B musician in those days, so, but that's Ray Charles anyway. But anyway, here he is with Just For a Thrill.
Just for a thrill, you chain the sunshine and rain. For a thrill. Turn my heart to pain. To me you were my pride and joy. But to you I was merely a toy. A plaything that you could toss around. Just for a thrill, baby. You made my life one sad song. Girl, you yearn me for a thrill, baby. Now. Yeah, I said you did it. Me alone, you left me by myself, but it's all right. Although you're free and having your fun, to me you're still the only one. Oh, you baby, made my heart stand still. Just for a thrill. Thank you.
still the only one. Girl, you do you, baby. Read my heart, stand still. Just for Andrew. Girl, you do you. Made my heart stir and still just for a thrill.
And now, I would like to, if you don't mind, ladies and gentlemen, take this great opportunity. I'm more than privileged. I'm thrilled, because this is my woman. I want to introduce you to the lady I love to death. Here's Miss Gladys Knight, if you don't mind.
actually very happy to be able to celebrate your 50 years of music making. When I was in Europe, I had never heard of your music, but in this country, you really represent the best that American music has to offer. Now, I don't think that I can give you any advice in my area of specialty in sex therapy, but maybe you can explain to me, what does it really mean, this chill out?
Like a stranger, stranger in my own hometown. Oh, sometimes I feel like a stranger in my own hometown. Some folks I've known since my childhood just don't seem to want me around, no. Y'all listen. I came home with good intentions about 5, 6 years ago. I did. I came home with good intentions, but it was just about 5 or 6 years ago. But my hometown won't accept me, and I just don't feel welcome here no more. Can you pick it up, son? Family man, I work hard in my kind of business, doing the very best I can. Now I don't mistreat nobody, and they lie to say I do. Now, I realize there's some here that like me, but they're so very, very few. So-called friends stop being friendly, but they can't keep a good man down. I'm like a stranger, stranger in my own hometown.
Don't rush it. In other words, just play it like it is. But the drum will keep you straight.
The uniqueness of Ray Charles as a singer, as an artist, is that he is able to, through his interpretation melody and a lyric make you feel as if you are going through the very experience that he's singing about, and equally that he has experienced every single one that he's singing about. So those moments of joy in the songs, and the moments of sorrow and pain, songs of hope, songs of pride. I guess that's one of the reasons why they call him the genius.
For purple mountain madness, above the fruit plane. Now wait a minute now. This America. You know, I wish I had somebody to help me sing this thing.
I was in Russia a few years ago, and we felt a little bit alienated. You know, no one was very friendly to us. This particular restaurant was kind of a jazz club restaurant. And someone at my table from the record company spoke to the band, the house band, and asked them if I could come up and do a song. And they pushed me up there, literally pushed me up there. And they announced that it was a Ray Charles classic, Georgia on My Mind. And everyone started uttering and repeating, Ray Charles, Ray Charles, Ray Charles. It was the only English we heard while we were there, all of a sudden, Ray Charles. And they all just started paying attention.
Oh, I like everything he does, but I've got, you know, favorites of mine. Georgia is one of my favorites, and then What I Say, and Don't Let the Sun Catch You Crying. And there's just so many Ray Charles. Just whatever he does becomes a classic.
Just another sweet sound, keeps Georgia on my mind. Oh, yeah. Oh, the arms reach out to me. Oh, the just for a thrill.
The way that one does survive for half a century in this business is by being consistently unique, incredible, inspiring, and just being talented. And that, I think, is how Ray Charles has been able to do it.
Well, what's about Ray Charles to get old or you know, out of date? Nothing. Everything he does is pure soul, and that never gets old.
Ray Charles is kind of that mark that so many people have been shooting for from the time they began doing this. You know, one of a handful of people that, with just a few broad sweeps, pretty much laid out what this pop music is all about, you know, for the rest of us. And,
thank you. The audience likes to know that you've given them yourself. And when I perform, I truly give the audience all of me. I am just overwhelmed by, I mean, everyone has been so marvelous to me. This is a great moment in my life, and I certainly would like to thank each and every one of the people who were so nice and kind to join me tonight. I want to say thanks again, ladies and gentlemen, because I know you all could have been someplace else tonight, too. Didn't have to be here with me, so I do want to say thanks again, and I'm going to try to get my drummer, because he's been waiting all night for this moment, just to play.
Now
if I was going to try to talk to any youngster coming up, the first thing I would tell any kid, you know, try to be honest with yourself to make sure that you have some real talent. Now, how you do that? You compare the little bit of stuff that you have with what you hear on the radio and so forth, and you don't fool yourself. But if you do have some talent, if there's some talent there, then you must remember there ain't, at least in my mind, there ain't no shortcuts. I've never known anybody that was great. I didn't say famous now. I said that was great in this business that didn't practice all the time. And that's what you got to do.
Although you're free, having your fun now, to me, you're still the only one that you made my heart stand still just for us. In my heart, stirring still, just for a thrill.
Thank you. Okay. I think what really knocked me out is the fact that so many people were so nice to stop doing what they, I'm sure, was very important to them to do. But they said, well, just for Brother Ray, because we love him so much. And I think that's about the greatest tribute that can be paid to anybody, when you know that people have other things to do, you know, but yet they put them aside to come and help you do whatever it is that you're trying to do, and they help you feel good and let you know that they love you. It's a wonderful thing, man. That's all I can tell you. And you know, and it's just a marvelous feeling to be well loved and respected. That's all I can tell you.
I really thank you very much. Matter of fact, I just would like to say to you, since you've been so wonderful to help me celebrate this first 50 years, I'd just like to know if you're going to help me continue to celebrate the second 50 years.